Today at Speedy's Garage, we're going to be working on some brake calipers. These are off of a 2003 Toyota Tundra, and they are 231 millimeter calipers, denoted by the 13WL that is stamped in the casting. These are a significant upgrade to the stock brakes that are on my 2002 4Runner. And believe it or not, they will bolt right up to the 4Runner spindle without any problems. The Tundras had two different brake caliper sizes on them through the years. The bigger ones, which were 13WLs, and the smaller ones, which were 199 millimeter, and they were marked with an SWE on the side. The 13WL are the ones you're going to want if you're doing this upgrade. I lucked out and found this set at a local salvage yard for about $35 a piece, which saved me a significant amount of money over purchasing brand new ones or remanufactured ones from the local parts store. I do have a gasket repair kit or a caliper rebuild kit coming from Toyota that will replace all the seals and gaskets in the calipers to make them like new. And I'm going to clean them up with some brake cleaner, some wire wheels on an angle grinder, and I'll finish up any spots I miss with some wire brushes. Now I've set the caliper up in a box to keep the spatter from getting all over me. And obviously you want to wear eye protection. And then you can just come in here, and you can do this with a drill too, but I've got an air tool, so I'm going to use it. But then you just... You can see how it's cleaning it up pretty good. So I'm going to do that to the whole caliper. So I've got one caliper completely cleaned up. I want to show the difference it makes. I'm going to paint these calipers, like I said, so they'll have a nice good base for that paint to adhere to. And I was careful not to touch anything inside. Number one, the brake pads are going to hide it in the rotor, so you're not going to see that anyway. Number two, I'm going to paint these calipers red, and the brake dust will turn it black. Leaving it alone on the inside of the caliper will make that harder to see, so they'll look cleaner. And number three, I didn't want to damage the pistons. You have to be very careful with those. So I didn't want to take a chance on the wire brush getting in there and rounding off an edge or gouging it or scratching it or something and giving me problems down the road. So I only clean the outside. And now I'll get to work on the other one. Okay, now that both calipers are nice and clean, I'm going to start with the rebuild process. And I'm using Toyota part number 044796-00081, which includes enough parts to rebuild two calipers. Okay, to perform the rebuild, you're gonna need some clamps. Particularly C clamps work the best. I've got a couple of locking clamps I'm gonna be using as well. Some long needle nose pliers, a pick, possibly a socket, an impact one would be the best. 10 millimeter wrench, a brush, some brake cleaner, and plenty of rags that you're okay with throwing away. This tool is optional for the rebuild, but I'm going to put a wire brush on the end of my angle grinder so that I can clean any rust out of the inside of the caliper pistons. You're obviously also going to be wearing eye protection when you perform this. You don't want to get brake fluid or any piece of debris in your eye. So I've placed the socket inside this cylinder. I'm going to use my 10 millimeter wrench to loosen the bleed barb on the caliper. I'm going to slowly depress the piston. And the reason I'm going to do this is because these calipers are full of fluid. And the more of it you can get out before you disassemble, the easier they're going to be to work with. You want to make sure you have a rag or something underneath it to catch the fluid that's going to run out. And just depress the pistons back till they're almost seated. This is going to be a messy job. It's not technically difficult, but it is a little bit tedious. Once you get one cylinder depressed, you can remove the clamp and the socket, move on to the next. You want to do that for all four to get as much fluid out of this as you can. The next thing you're going to do is you're going to remove these dust seals and then you're going to use compressed air. You're going to remove this connection. This is where your factory brake line would come in. So you're going to remove this connection. You're going to put compressed air here and push the pistons out until you can just take them out of the caliper. And just for your general knowledge, the way a brake caliper works is the brake fluid passes into the caliper through this port. It travels through the caliper in channels. There's one that goes here across the two halves. The caliper is actually two pieces. Across the two halves, or this caliper is actually two pieces. Some of them aren't, but this one is. Across the two halves, comes back down through this channel and completes the loop. When you depress the brake pedal, it pressurizes the fluid in these cylinders and forces the pistons to contact the rotor. Now we're going to remove the old dust seals. We're going to use a pick to do that. You're not going to reuse them. It's not a big deal if you break them or tear them. They just pop right off. Now, there's supposed to be a metal retaining ring that goes around this and holds this in place. If yours doesn't have them, don't worry about it. You're rebuilding them anyway. But if they are there, you can use your hook to just grab a hold of it and pop it right off if it does happen to be present. Okay, now we're going to remove this little port where the factory brake line went in using our 10 millimeter wrench. And you want to make sure you remember to retighten the bleeder barb here. We're going to use compressed air from a blowgun and gently, with like 20-25 psi, just short bursts of air to push the pistons out. You're going to need some blocks of wood because the pistons aren't all just going to come out at the exact same speed and at the exact same time. You definitely do not want to have your hands in here when you're putting compressed air there. If one of those comes loose, it can mash a finger pretty easy. So we're going to use some blocks of wood to kind of set it up and push one out at a time. And then when we get that one out as far as it's going to go, we'll put a piece of wood here, work on this one, work on this one, work on this one, until we get all four of those to where we can just pull them out by hand. Okay, you can see I've also used a couple of clamps. Made it a little bit easier to hold these two pistons in place. You kind of have to get creative with these and just figure out a way to make it work. You want to make sure you're covering up this hole with a rag while you're putting compressed air to it, because there is brake fluid in there, and when you release the pressure, it wants to spray out. So this will kind of protect the surrounding area. You just want to give it light bursts of pressure. See, that one just popped out, but the other ones didn't really move too much. And if one comes out, it's going to lose the seal right there. So you have to actually push it back in by hand just enough that it makes contact with the square cut gaskets inside so that it seals. Then you can begin working the other ones and get those to move out. Okay, I got them all moved out to just the edges. Now I can wiggle them out by hand. So there's your cylinder. And you want to make sure when you're cleaning these up, make sure the walls are nice and smooth without any scratches. This is what makes your brakes work. This part's critical. They usually look pretty good. There's not much in there that can damage them unless the dust boots were really bad and they got sand or something in there that scored them up. These look pretty good. So we're going to take all four of these out and clean them up. Okay, I want to show you what you're looking for. So you can see the cylinder wall is nice and smooth. This is one I've just started to wipe off. You can see a lot of debris underneath that edge there. That's what you want to clean up. You don't want anything like that on the cylinder when you're done. And there's the inside that I'm going to clean up with the wire wheel on the angle grinder. A lot of brake cleaner, brake parts cleaner, a rag, and a plastic brush. Don't use anything metal, don't use sandpaper, don't use anything on this other than plastic. Toothbrush will work, but I've got some shop brushes I use and microfiber towels. And here's one that I've already cleaned, so you can see what they're supposed to look like when you're finished. Just like new. There's the inside. Now we've got the cylinders cleaned up, we want to take out the square cut gaskets that are inside these channels. And these are obviously being thrown out, so you don't have to worry about tearing them or anything. I hope you can see this. Try to get the light where you can see them, but you just pop it out just like that. Very easy. That's what you're getting right there. There's four of these. The only thing you want to be careful of is when you're pulling these out, do not scratch the cylinder wall there. If you do, run a risk of it leaking, and then you've pretty much trashed the caliper. And just a little gently with the hook and you can pull it right out. Once those are out, take a rag, wipe the cylinders out real well. You can even use some brake cleaner in there if you want. Get that, all that old brake fluid out of there. When you're cleaning up the cylinders, you want to pay particular attention to that ledge right there. Make sure that that is really clean before you start reassembly. I'm going to use a lot of brake cleaner and a plastic brush to clean that up real well. So that's about what you're looking for on the cylinder. Try to get it about that clean. Cleaner the better. So now we're ready to start reassembly. For reassembly, we're going to start by installing the square cut seals. These came from Toyota, like I said, and they're already pre-greased. They got a light coat of grease on them. If yours for some reason do not, there should be some grease in the kit. So you want to put a little bit of that on them. And it's just a matter of setting them in the cylinder and letting them snap into place. Now you just want to be careful. The only thing you have to watch out for here is not letting them roll. You want to make sure that they are square, because they're square cut seals. So they should snap into place. And you want to double check them once you get them inserted to make sure none of them have a roll in them. These are critical to the operation of the caliper because they are what seals the piston to the cylinder wall. So there's what you're looking for on a properly installed square cut seal. Now we can start to reinsert the pistons. Inserting the pistons are pretty straightforward. You're gonna put a little bit of your grease on each piston to make it easier to seat around the gasket. And then you just set it in there nice and square and gently work it in. And don't push them in too far. Just push them in maybe a quarter of an inch to get them started, because that's going to make it easier for the next step when we put on the dust boot. Next, you want to install the new dust seals over the pistons. It's pretty straightforward. There's a big end and a little end. Obviously, the little end goes over the piston, the big end goes over the cylinder wall, we'll call it. You want to put a nice coat of grease on these, because you don't want to tear them. Grease is a good thing when it comes to rubber gaskets. Helps them slide on easier and be less prone to damage. You just slide it over the piston. You may have to work a little bit to make the lips of the gasket line up correctly, or dust boot rather, and then just stretch it down over the bottom of the cylinder. It should go on pretty easy. And do that for all four, obviously. So when you get the dust boots installed, that's what you're looking for. The edge should be right up against the lip of the cylinder, and the bottom should be over the lip of the cylinder wall. You want to check it all the way around on all four to make sure all of them are the same. Now we can install the dust boot retaining ring. Okay, for installing the dust boot retaining ring, I found it easiest if you pull it apart till it's end on end coat it with a generous coat of grease, set it on the lip of the cylinder wall, and start to ease it around. Put some grease on this one. Make sure it hooks on the lip, and then just force it. Around the edge. And if any of these rings give you trouble, just put more grease on it. That's worked for me every time one was difficult. Just put a little more grease on there and it went right on. So when you get finished, that's what you're looking for. Now I put the open side towards the hub so that it would be hidden. You're not gonna be able to see it anyway. But I put them on the inside just so they're all uniform. When you're looking at these, I'm going to check the front and the back to make sure they're evenly seated all the way around. Finally, just use a little hand pressure. Push the pistons back enough to clear the rotor. Don't push them back too far, just enough to clear the rotor. And install your dust boot for the bleeder valve. A little bit of grease helps it go a long way. Now you've rebuilt a brake caliper. The next thing I'm going to do is paint these with some G2 caliper paint so that they don't rust and look trashy on the car. Rebuilding a caliper isn't too much of a big deal. It's a little time consuming and tedious, but considering the amount of money you save versus getting some remanufactured ones from the parts store, and how easy it actually is, I think it's worth it.